In this video, we're going to name three types of acid where the anion ends with IDE, ATE, and ITE. We're going to look at how to name acids using these three examples, HCl, HClO3, and HClO2. HCl is an acid that doesn't contain oxygen, while HClO3 and HClO2 are acids that contain oxygen. The guidelines in naming acid is very simple. We look at the name of the anion. For HCl, the anion is chloride, which is Cl-. For HClO3, its anion is ClO3-, which is called chlorate. And the anion for HClO2 is ClO2-, which is called chlorite. ClO3- and ClO2- are both polyatomic ions. Once we know the name of the anion, we'll follow these simple guidelines. If the anion ends with IDE, we'll insert the prefix hydro and suffix IC acid. Prefix refers to the term that comes in front of the name, and suffix refers to the term that is added at the end. Therefore, for chloride, we replace the IDE and we add in hydro in front and IC acid at the back. And that gives the name HCl as hydrochloric acid. For the anion that ends with ATE, we're going to replace the ATE with IC acid. So in our example, chlorate, we replace the ATE and we put in IC acid. So the name for HClO3 is therefore chloric acid. Last but not least, anion that ends with ITE. We replace the ITE with the suffix OUS acid. So for our example, chlorite, we replace the ITE with OUS acid. So the name for HClO2 is therefore chlorous acid. These simple guidelines work for pretty much all the anions except for phosphate, phosphite, sulfate, and sulfite. For some reason, we can't just simply replace the ATE and ITE with the suffixes for these ions. We need to add in a few more letters when naming these acids. With that, we're done naming the acid with anion that ends with IDE, ATE, and ITE. Here are two more videos that might interest you. Thanks for watching all the way till the end. If you find this video helpful, be sure to like and share it with someone. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell icon so you won't miss future videos. Your support means a lot to me.